Organizations that successfully transform their cultures do not view culture, strategy, and leadership separately. Together, these components drive high-performance culture and create superior value for all stakeholders. This then shows where we are and where we want to get to. So together with our group executive committee, we critically reviewed our leadership approach and considered the feedback received through a company-wide culture survey called Heartbeat, which we undertook in 2016. Subsequently, we also held leadership interviews and workshops with our extended leadership teams. Culture does not change in a year or two, so our change approach is long-term and holistic. We have sought to achieve fundamental shifts from some of the barriers we identified through the Heartbeat survey and holding the mirror interviews we conducted. Holding the mirror was a process of taking facts such as what are the exit interviews saying, what is the staff turnover saying, so that the conversations are also fact-based, not based on only on opinion. This process enabled us to define leadership style and approach, which we believe will be instrumental in bringing our aspirational culture to life. The way in which we show up and how we are perceived as leaders contributes to the value we create for our organization and, more importantly, for our people. When we started talking about embedding the aspirational culture with the extended leadership team, we all agreed that one of the biggest barriers to culture change was our leadership style. Although Sasol is characterized by strong leadership, our leadership style, by and large, tended towards command and control, given the nature of our business and operations, which is not uncommon in similar companies, because I've seen a bit of this in the previous organizations which are in the same industry. However, this style is not conducive to encouraging constructive engagement to our teams, nor to bring their best performance and A game to the company. The shift we needed is to move towards more inspiring and authentic leadership style that is more rooted in trust, respect, and engagement. Because the previous style always resulted in fear to speak and silence. Therefore, if you can't hear your people, you can't improve. After extensive consultation and dialogue, we agreed that the kind of Sasol leader that would effectively lead the transition towards the aspirational culture will be inspirational, care for people, live the Sasol values, drive high performance and innovation. What we really need is what we term multiplier leaders, those who create positive energies for the employees to bring their best performance and ideas to work every day. We have adopted what we call multiplier behaviors, which were pioneered by Liz Wiseman. Successful leaders who are multipliers grow others. To contextualize, we identified 5 key multiplier behaviors to characterize our desired leadership style. The first one is a talent magnet. Hires smart people and identifies their strengths to put them to work. Actually, as a leader, you should not think you have answers to all. You should look for the whole, but your people individually do not be insecure if they are stronger than you, because as a whole, you'll be stronger as an organization. A liberator gives people space to think and expect their best work. A challenger gives people stretch opportunities and expect them to go beyond what you and they previously thought possible. A debate maker, they set up debates before decision is made, ensure people understand the issues at hand, and they can quickly support and execute. Somebody with a different view to you doesn't necessarily mean that they are opposed to you. It simply means they think differently. And by accommodating the views which are different, you end up with a stronger, more holistic picture. And last but not least, you need an investor so that you give ownership and hold people accountable and deliver results. So it's not just a fluffy, good to see thing, you have to actually deliver on results. So to enable our leaders to adopt these behaviors, we have a program that we call the Lead Sasol Program, which provides practical tools to enable our leaders to adopt these behaviors. Our leaders that span across layers continue to participate and have responded very positively to the program, and it continues to be rolled out across the group.